All right, welcome you back to another section of my tutorial. The aspect of making a painting of your sketched work. To me, this your sketching is this character base to every other thing you're going. If your sketching is very wrong, my dear, or my bro, or my sis. Your work will be so poor. As you can see the sketch, everything is like okay, it's neat. Even with this now, you can already see the whoever you're sketching the beauty in it. So that's just basically it. So right now I'm gonna apply my paint on it. Very easy. I've already done the sketch work, making sure there's no lapses and all that. So I'll teach you how to get the clothes off, working on the clothes here and then painting it. So that's basically what I'm gonna be doing in this segment of my tutorial. So just stay close. So working on this, you will make use of your bucket wand, your magic wand to your bucket to apply most of the images. Cut out different type of but just stay close and try understand what I'm doing. Well, thank you. So let me select. Basically, I did most of the major sketching on my outline, so that will be very instrumental. Let me turn off the others and so you see what I'm talking about. Line out. So. We are about getting the clothes off. I not say with the naked ammo, those people that have dirty mind. So click on this, Control C, Control V. Oh, sorry. There's a problem here. Now our original image is carrying some things that I really don't want. You getting me? So you thank God you watch me do some magic stuff, of which is it's also easily can be done anywhere. So I want to remove the self crush. I wonder why she didn't place the self crush there, because it's gonna affect every other thing. I don't want it there. Thank God. No, yeah. Glory be to God. No other thing apart from that. So we'll be getting that off. So I'll take this here. So doing that, we're going to access our clone tool. I'm going to teach you how to use this clone tool. So I'll use it on the background. Our ally to be on your background. Then clone tool and use holding your alternate outside, because this is the place I want. I want to pick the color from here and apply it at the down here. So holding my alternate, clicking on my secondary button and just removing and taking your mouse down and that's it. Just start applying it. Look at that. Oh. There was something here. How did it leave? How did you do it? How did you do it? This is actually the way to do that. There are different ways of doing this actually, but this is my own method. Just did hold my alternate. You have to be careful with this, but if it was actually a real picture that I'm editing, I have to zoom it very well so I won't I want it to be neat. reduce it on one. Oh no. Don't really have the time for this. I won't know. Okay, I think you should be okay like this. So that's it. So put it on our outline, click on the top and make sure it's on your background. Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V. Let me make it white and take the top up. So you send it there. Up next will be making it, putting a color on the face and all that. So we'll do that beneath your outline. So create a layer beneath your outline, give it a name, skin. Give it a name, skin. Skin. And let's pick our skin color. This is the color chart I normally use. Head color, skin, hex code. Don't worry, I'll give you codes to get this skin color. So click on that. Normally make use of this. So hold. Pick our magic wand, make sure it's on the outline, and then select those places you know are the skin. If you notice, I'm having a leakage down here, so I have to select. Okay, then do that area and Ctrl D. So I'll just use my pencil to and as easy as drawing it. I'll just draw it. Okay, draw it down. Okay, let's select again, holding my shift so I can select other points. Take my hand off the shift button, grab my pocket tool, switch the color, make sure your helmet is on the skin and you apply. Ctrl D to deselect so I can cover these lapses. It plays a very vital role when doing what you go back to my brushes, back to when I use a hard brush on this. Make sure you're on your skin and just paint and cover stuff like this. I try to love this work. Seriously, I don't know about it. So up next will be the lips and eyes. So I'll create another layer beneath the skin. Are you understanding? Follow this procedure because it will be a lifesaver. Me, I cannot explain. Do much explanation, but if you go beneath the gun, be putting these lips and skin above the skin, you have issues when making your paint, especially when painting the background. So outline and click on that lip. Look, it's normally pink or something like that. Just select your color. Use your bucket to make sure it's on neutral. Yeah. Ctrl D to deselect. Grab your brush and paint. Just perfect. Now for the eyes, I'm gonna use a soft brush. Take this to white. I will set the color there using my white meshes and brush. Press it. Now turn off this black. Turn off the white. And take it up. I don't paint it completely. I just leave a little edge for the. You know, your eyes normally have this a little thing here. You know what I mean? Here. I hope you are understanding. Okay, so that's just that for that. remember to always save your work. Controversy. So, I made a mistake here. I'm not supposed to paint it now. I'm supposed to paint it on here, but it doesn't also mean you can also paint it here or paint it here. Same effect will still be there because you're going to still use this. So, up next now we'll be taking taking the image out and all that. So, I'm going to show you how you're going to do that. I'm going to duplicate the original image, take it to the top, grab our magic wand, click on your outline, click outside the boxes and every other places that part that are not part of the images outside here and here, because I'm taking that out. Go to your eraser tool, make sure your eraser is on the hard brush, erase it so you can just erase it efficiently, click on the top and then voila, into this. It won't even affect your image. It only take off the background. You can also use this, like always, so you can also use it for your normal image editing. So click on the black and that's it. Do same to the black backgrounds you colored earlier on if you have been following this tutorial. So Ctrl D to disable and turn this off. So that's it. I think this hair I would just love. I want it to be a little bit dark. So I'll Control J, make it a little bit dark, and hold my shift, group this. And, I'll start for this thing. This top. Let me just show you how to make the top look, you know, presentable. So we'll go to the layer. Name this shirt so you know. If you like, you can leave everything layer like. But so the important thing is that you know what you are working on. So I'll go under my filter, click on my smart blur. I don't use this smart blur. I use formally. Don't worry. As we're going, I'll be showing you so much things I can do to close like this. So make sure it's high, normal, your just is just high, that's all. Click on your OK button. Just wait for it to take its OK. So when this is done, I just easily go to my burn and dodge tool, or use the burn tool and increase it a little bit. Increase the size and then just apply it. I also love looking at the original image so I know what I'm doing. Okay. So let us go to the dodge. That makes it lighter. So that's it, and thank you for staying with me. Our next tutorial will be on the blending, making a blend work of everything, to give it that perfect look. So this is just part of the processes. So thank you, and see you on my next tutorial.